Opening credits. NLP Dark Psychology. Learn the dark secrets of persuasion, manipulation, deception, emotional control, and brainwashing with the power of Neuro-Linguistic Programming, also known as NLP. Written by Timothy Willink of the Dark Psychology Academy. Narrated by Maurice Roberts. Introduction. There are many ways in which you can benefit or be harmed by psychology during your daily life. In this book, you will learn how to not only reap its benefits, but also how to protect yourself from harm. One aspect of dark psychology that is especially powerful, but greatly misunderstood, is neuro-linguistic programming. This method, also known as NLP, is essentially brainwashing. We may think of brainwashing as something that only rarely happens to individuals who have undergone torturous situations, but this is not true. In fact, many of us can be brainwashed and never even realize it. In order to protect yourself from brainwashing and use it to your advantage, you need to learn how it works and its techniques. In this book, you will learn everything you need to excel in dark psychology and neuro-linguistic programming. It may be difficult to use at first, but you will find that with knowledge and practice, you can make steady progress. Before long, you'll be an expert at NLP. But what is NLP used for? In the professional medical field, it's often used in order to treat stress, low self-esteem, anxiety disorders, depression, and post-traumatic stress disorder. But it can be used in other ways as well. In your daily life, people may slowly begin to replace your own ideas and beliefs with those that they want you to adopt. This process takes time, meaning it happens too slowly for you to notice it's happening. People can use this in order to manipulate and persuade others into following what the brainwasher desires. Brainwashing, such as this, is how many people get sucked into cults and abusive relationships, but it can happen in much more ordinary, everyday situations as well. Whether you're looking to protect yourself from brainwashing, the ability to better recognize when your loved ones are being brainwashed, or hope to learn how to use these techniques yourself, you will find the answers you seek within the following pages. Chapter 1. Are you being reprogrammed? The average person has no idea what neuro-linguistic programming is. Upon first learning about it, people may think that this form of brainwashing is either something that only happens in the movies or is a form of manipulation. But this is not the case. In fact, neuro-linguistic programming is something very real and used on a daily basis. While NLP may sometimes involve manipulating people, it is not in itself a form of manipulation. In this chapter, we will begin explaining the basic principles behind NLP and how you can know if you're being reprogrammed against your will. NLP in itself is not something harmful or damaging. You can use it for either good or evil. Just as you would say that a knife in itself is not something harmful. Knives can not only be used to harm people, but they can also aid in preparing food and help us to survive. The same is true of neuro-linguistic programming, as it can be used to help or harm others. You may seek a professional who can use NLP to help you overcome difficulties, or you may find that people in your daily life are abusing you with these methods. Whether it's used for good or bad completely depends on the person who's using it. Thankfully, you don't have to be at the mercy of other people. You don't have to allow others to influence or abuse you with NLP methods against your will or knowledge. But what exactly is neuro-linguistic programming? While it can certainly be used to brainwash people, it does not have to be used in this way. In fact, it is frequently used professionally to help consenting people with their mental health. NLP analyzes the various patterns within language and communication, including verbal and nonverbal cues. The name neuro-linguistic programming may be long, but it effectively communicates the basics of this process. Neuro references that this process is centered on the mind. Linguistic refers to the fact that it is based on communication. And lastly, programming refers to the way in which our mind and communication both program major aspects of our body and our behavior. There are several dominant senses that humans use on a near constant basis. These senses include auditory, visual, touch, smell, and taste. The last three are also known scientifically as kinesthetic, olfactory, and gustatory. While neuro-linguistic programming can involve all of these senses, it focuses most on auditory, visual, and touch. Neuro-linguistic programming researchers and practitioners study the way in which people experience the world and think. This is difficult to measure with strict scientific methods, as there's no machine that can analyze this. There are models that practitioners use for reference. These models of the human mind allow the practitioners to create techniques to both effectively and quickly alter the way a person thinks and their behaviors. Oftentimes, they focus on changing thoughts and behavior patterns that limit the individual, holding them back in life. The power of NLP lies in its ability to effectively change these thoughts, beliefs, and behaviors. As you can imagine, this can be a powerful tool when used with a person's consent for good, but it can also lead to disastrous results on a person's psyche if it's used in order to take advantage of them or cause them harm. Neuro-linguistic programming focuses largely on communication and the senses we use while communicating with others. You may think that because of this, it would largely focus on the words used in communication, but this is not necessarily the case.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.